أشهد أن محمد رسول
أشهد أن محمد رسول
أشهد أن محمد
أشهد أن
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي
على الفلاح. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي على الفلاح.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي على الفلاح.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. الله أكبر الله أعظم
لا إله إلا الله
حقا لا إله إلا الله محمد عبده ورسوله اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة محمد المسيح والفضيلة وبعث درجة عالية رفيعة مقام المحمود الذي وعدته إنك لا تخف من حسن الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة أولا بتقوى الله فاتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون ثم أما بعد All praise are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most gracious and the most merciful the best of his peace and blessings shall be bestowed upon his beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and upon those that follow his footsteps. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, in the last khutbah, last Friday, we spoke about a very important outcome of Ramadan. We spoke about the way to reach a rushd. We said it all starts with love, al-hubb. As Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله. To love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to hate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we've explained and I urge you all to go back to that khutbah. This is a continuation. That we love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love actions, we love people for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we hate the actions that are not in compliance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's orders. This is a must. This is our iman. And we learned that as-sahaba, that was their main attribute. إن الله سبحانه وتعالى زين لهم الإيمان حبب لهم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبهم إن الله سبحانه وتعالى beautify الإيمان and make them love إيمان وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان as the ayah said in سورة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم Allah made them hate الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، كفر بالله سبحانه وتعالى. Which is big, but not only kufr that we hate. You can't just hate the kufr and say I'm okay with other actions. Even the fusuq, straying from the right path. Even the asiyan, even sins, you have to hate them. Because this is the real driver for humanity, love and hate. This is how we operate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us this way. And we said this love and hate, and in hate there's something called al-bara wal-wala. When you hate, you disown. You know, I hate this action because it's haram and it's harmful. We hate drugs, haram and harmful. I disown it, meaning I have nothing to do with it. Never endorse it, never talk, speak well about it, never promote it, because it's haram, it's harmful to humanity. And it's haram because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. And then we reach marhalat ar-rushd. By having this love for us, mainly for our children, to be raised with this love and hate mechanism, they reach ar-rushd. Ulaika humur rashidun. And ar-rushd is being self-guided. They have an internal system that will help them navigate. They help them be strong, not just navigate. What's more important than navigation is to be able to stand strong under or in front of challenges and pressures. And we've all learned how it is important for us to be successful is to withstand turbulations. Wallahi, I'm driven, I'm motivated in a smooth ride. Well, we all know it's never going to be a smooth ride. We all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَقُولُوا أَفَحَسِبَ النَّاسَ يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُوا. There's no such a thing as a smooth ride if you want to reach success. There are turbulations, tests, challenges. What makes you strong? Standing tall in front of challenges is this love and hate. You love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much, you love al-Iman so much, you hold on to it. And you hate al-Kufr wal-Fusuq wal-Usiyan, you don't want to get even near it. You're driven, charged. Listen to this ayah that supports this entire concept. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in a famous ayah, لا إكراه في الدين. We just said it's about love and hate. It's not about force. You cannot force yourself or your children or anybody to become a Muslim. What's a Muslim? It's a love and hate relationship. How can you force someone's heart? This is exactly why you cannot force anybody. They have to love it and hold on to it so they can fight for it. So they can stand in front of the challenges and the turbulations. لا إكراه في الدين. There's no force, or there's no deen by force. And ulama said لا إكراه في الدين means this will negate deen that comes through إكراه. المسلم بالإكراه ليس مسلم. لا إكراه في الدين, it's because it's by heart. قد تبين الرشد من الغي. Mainly when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, mainly when الرشد من الغي, the right path from the wrong path, from the ضلالة, is clear. And we look around us now, it's becoming more and more clear. And this is from the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is separating الرشد من الغي for us. Our ummah lived for a very long time confused. We see الحق باطل والباطل حق. We see people that we thought من أهل الجنة ومن أهل الله, we realize that they're not. This confusion is by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is diminishing. And now we look around us, we see الحق من الباطل. We see leaders governments and umam speak about values, and we see them, how these values are only applied for certain people. We see the nifaq, we see the hypocrisy. It's not hidden anymore. And this is wallahi a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when we continuously live under this hypocrisy, we think, wallahi, things are good. We're fooled, we're deceived. We don't know how to make proper decisions. But now, alhamdulillah, قَدْ تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيْبِ. The path are clear. We know who's a hypocrite, we know who's genuine. We know the right and the wrong. It appeared good to me. I was deceived. خلاص. قَدْ تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيْبِ. This is a step closer to the improvement of the condition of earth in general, when we know خلاص, النفاق is clear, hypocrisy is clear, we're going to be moving on to what's better inshallah. قَدْ تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيْبِ. Okay, so what happened if تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيْبِ? What happened if you, ya Muslim, you know that this is wrong? What happened if mothers know and fathers know that certain movies and movie productions like Disney, we know with absolute certainty that it's destroying our kids? When we used to say this 10 years ago, 15 years ago, come on, this is just cartoon. That was confusion, deception. Now we know, everybody knows, these cartoons are designed to destroy our children's moralities and belief. Is there still anybody on earth that doesn't believe this? Unless they're sleeping under a stone. خلاص, we know. تبين الرشد. This is one example where there was absolute confusion over children programs and cartoons. A lot of people thinking these are innocent programs. Let the children sit in front of TV for 10 hours, destroy their deen, destroy their minds, destroy their health, and they say it's innocent. Now we know. طيب قد تبين الرشد من الغي. And I'm speaking to the mothers mainly here and the fathers. This is just one example. What do we do عندما يتبين الرشد من الغي? In the same ayah. فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله. The two things that we need to do when things are clear. First of all, كفر بالطاغوت. Before الإيمان بالله. Because التخلية قبل التحلية. If you want to elevate your status, first thing you need to do is التخلية. تتخلى عن الذنوب والمعاصي و. التخلية is to let go of everything bad. You have a cup. You want to fill it with clear water. But it's already filled with filthy, unhealthy water. What do you do? You don't pour the clean water over the dirty water. Because you're going to waste. The little drop of dirt would contaminate the water. You need to تخلية. To dump the dirty water, clean the cup, then pour the new water. Why? Because you want it to be clear, pure, beneficial, no contamination. So this is exactly what the ayah is saying. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. You need to perform كُفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ. That's the only كُفُرْ you're allowed to do. تَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ means, مَا هُوَ الطَّاغُوتِ? الطاغوت من الطغيان, من طغى, المبالغة في الطغيان. الطاغوت is everything, everybody, every human, every corporation, every whatever that's exaggerating the spread of sins and خبائث and wrong, destroying humanities. These are طواغيت. Exaggeration in contaminating our children's minds. These are tawaghit. Exaggeration in destroying people's beliefs and religions. These are tawaghit. Wrong deviant ideas. These are طواغيت. عليك أن تكفر بالطاغوت. So step number one, كيف تكفر بالطاغوت؟ ما هو الكفر؟ What is الكفر؟ It's to cover, to hide, and to distance yourself from. This is الكفر. You have to be vocal about it and tell others, this is a طاغوت, be careful. This is a طاغوت, be careful. Don't mean to point at anybody. Be careful from the طاغوت. Stay away from the طاغوت. Cleanse yourself from the طاغوت. And then, وَيُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ. If you're successful in cleansing yourself from the طاغوت, you fill your heart with iman, replacing the طاغوت in our heart, or the effect of the طاغوت in our heart, what happened? فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى لَنْفِصَامَ لَهَا وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you perform after seeing everything clear, right and wrong, الرشد من الغي, كفرنا بالطاغوت, خلاص, we're away, we distance ourselves from الطواغيت and الطاغوت, we're strong about it, we're vocal, we're open, and we increase our iman بالله سبحانه وتعالى, فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى. العروة الوثقى is the strong closed net tied, a rope that they used to make to hold a jug, so the water will not fall or the jug will not drop and fall. Any tight net is urwa wuthqa, very strong. Stamsaka, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say masaka. Masak is when you hold, but when you hold, the grip might not be strong. And you're not working hard when you're just holding something. But istamsaka means there's a challenge. Means you're trying your best not to let go. Istamsaka. You're holding. So even with kufr bil-taghut, wal iman billah, fi istamsak, there's always a challenge going to be there, but you're going to hold really tight. Bil-urwa al-wuthqa, al-urwa al-wuthqa, awthaqa al-urwa al-iman, alayhi salam said, in the hadith, الحب في الله والبغض في الله. العروة الوثقة التي لا انفصام لها. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about, as Mufassirin said, is your deen. You're holding on to your deen. If this is your goal. Because you'll be talking to some people and say, let's do this because we need to protect our deen. Well, what else can I get out of it? Wallahi, if, disclaimer. If your deen is not your goal, this is not for you. We're talking to people that care about their deen, ya akhi. If your goal is to protect your deen, the deen of your children, then listen up and act. If it's not, don't waste your time and ours. فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى لَنْفِصَامَ لَهَا. Will never break. And a beautiful translation or interpretation by Sha'rawi rahmatullah alayhi said, لَنْفِصَامَ لَهَا means, and difference between انفصام and انقسام, انقسام, when it breaks, and it's still tied. There's still a tied at a certain point. انفصام is complete separation. لَنْفِصَامَ لَهَا. If you perform the تخلية and the تحلية, you تكفر بالطاغوت وتحب في الله وتكره في الله, you perform all these things, even if you trip, لنفصام لها, you're not going to be disconnected. This is why we see, and I've witnessed, and many of us witness, children raised in families with great iman, they might divert at one point in their life, but they come back and they come back stronger. Why? عروة وثقى لنفصام لها, سبحان الله. The rope will never be disconnected. They will come back. So it's to your advantage, knowing the challenges that our children face, we raise them with these attributes of love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if لا قدر الله something happened, they divert, rest assured they will come back. والله سميع عليم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all hearing and all knowing. He knows what's in our heart. If our niyyah is to do it properly, but we fail, He will make up our failure. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا فيا فوز المستغفرين. أستغفر الله العظيم. أستغفر الله العظيم وأتوب إليه. أستغفر الله العظيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Now this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters, is preceded by ayat al-Kursi, which is, as per the ahadith, the greatest ayah in the Holy Quran. Ayat al-Kursi, that talks about عظمت وجلال الله سبحانه وتعالى. It has 5 of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names and 20 of his attributes. Amazing ayah. And this ayah, as we all know in the ahadith, is a protection, physical and spiritual. Reading this ayah as instructed by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam every day after salah, when you wake up, before you go to sleep, protects you. But here we see that it also protects your iman, which is our topic. It's for us to focus that we need to protect our deen, our iman, and our children, not just ours, generations to come, because the deen is under attack. We know it. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you ayat al-Kursi, the ayah of protecting your iman, then is telling you what to do. Look at the connection, beautiful connection between the ayat. And the following ayah, which puts it really clear, Allah waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min al-dhulumati ila al-nur. Waladhina kafaru awliyahum al-taghut yukhrijunahum min al-nuri ila al-dhulumat. Ulaika ashabun nar hum fiha khalidun. In the following ayah of the action items, Allah is telling us, Allah waliyu alladhina amanu. You do this, you become waliyullah. You want to become min awliya Allah? You want Allah? What does wali mean? Wali, an yali shay, wa aqrabu shay ba'da aw ilayh. Yali is right next to it. Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be next to you all the time. And also when he's next to you, subhanahu. And this is what we ended with, the last ayah of ayat al-siyam. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. To who? وَجِبُوا دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. If I want to do this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِيِّ Allah. اللهم اجعلنا جميعا من أولياء الله. When he's next to you, that means if you trip and fall and you're screaming, he's the first one who will hear your call. He's the one that's going to stand beside you. He's the one that's going to lift you up and take care of you, because you got in closer to him. Do this, Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu, and will take you out of from dhulumat to nur. And how many of us feel that we live in darkness? Prices going up, huge attacks on our deen, empty promises by politicians, economy is getting bad, everything. You feel that you live in dhulumat. And it's indeed dhulumat, it's darkness, it's heavy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yukhrijna min al-dhulumati ila al-nur, insha'Allah, bi-idhnillah. Allah will lift us out of the dhulumat to the guidance. Not just dhulumat al-kufr, dhulumat al-hayah, darkness and being away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, darkness of all challenges of life. Allah will deliver you if that's what you're looking for. And know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said at the end, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, those that reject al-Iman, hide al-Iman, أَوْلِيَاؤُهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ, their close friends and allies are الطَّاغُوت, the ones that we started off with, that are spreading fasad, exaggerating in destroying humanity, both mentally and physically and psychologically and everything. أَوْلِيَاهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ, those ones that are the allies of الطَّاغُوت. What are they going to do to them? يُخْرِجُونَهُمْ مِنَ النُّورِ إِلَى الظُّلُمَاتِ. They will take them out of light to darkness. أَنْ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. They will be taken out of nur to darkness to the light of جهنم والعياذ بالله. خالدون perpetually forever. That was their choice based on al-muwala. Here it is very clear. You won't be an ally of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يخرجك من الظلمات إلى النور. You want to be an ally of الطواغيت. يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات. أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من أوليائه يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من أوليائك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من أوليائك. اللهم أخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم أخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم أخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم اهدنا واهدي بنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. اللهم اغفر لنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا أكرم الأكرمين يا أرحم الراحمين احفظ علينا ديننا. اللهم احفظ أبناءنا واحفظ ذرياتنا. اللهم انشئهم نشأة في طاعتك يا رب العالمين. إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. اللهم يا الله اللهم نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم عافنا في ديننا. اللهم عافنا في دنيانا. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا واحفظنا من بين يدينا ومن خلفنا وعن يميننا ومن شمائلنا ومن تحتنا ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى صحبه أجمعين. وأنت يا أخي أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح وقام للصلاة وقام للصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
حق ان خليها استقيموا اعتدلوا استووا. Close the gap, straight up, straight your lines. Remember that you're standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stand up with utmost respect and courtesy. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم. الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم الصالحين الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله